Welcome students. Today's session, some activities related to classification of materials on the basis of their solubility in water. You all of you know that water dissolves a large number of materials, but it cannot dissolve all the materials. Thus, some materials are soluble in water, whereas other materials are insoluble in water. So, all the materials can be classified into two groups on the basis of their solubility. So to understand this, here today some activities we are performing. In activity 1, take two test tubes, fill it with water. In first test tube, add some sugar and shake it well. We will find that the sugar has disappeared into water. We said that the sugar has dissolved in water or that the sugar is soluble in water. Please note that sugar is still there in water, but its particles have become so small and spread so uniformly in water that it cannot be seen them. From this activity, we can conclude that sugar is material which is soluble in water. So some materials which are soluble in water, common salt, washing soda, copper sulfate, glycerin, alcohol, all this. So we can say that water having sugar dissolved in it is called the sugar solution. Water plays an important role in the functioning of our body because it can dissolve a large number of substances. Now take another test tube and again fill it with water and add some sand to it. Shake it well and observe it. We will find that the sand settles down at the bottom of the test tube. Sand does not dissolve in the water. From this activity, we conclude that sand is a material which is insoluble in water. Some more materials which are insoluble in water are chalk powder, sulfur, glass, plastic paper, mustard oil, etc. In second activity, we will discuss solubility of some liquids in water. Glycerin is a liquid material. Take test tube, fill it with water, add some glycerin to it. Shake the test tube well. Allow it to stand for some time and observe. We will see that the glycerin has completely mixed with water to form a single layer. So, we can say that the glycerin is soluble in water. So, now we can also say that the liquid is miscible with water. So, in this case, we can say that the glycerin is miscible with water. Some more liquids which are soluble in water or miscible with water are milk, lemon juice, vinegar, alcohol. You can try it. Take one beaker, take in that fill water and add some milk into it. You will see that the milk has completely soluble in water. You can say that the milk is miscible with water. Another, take mustard oil. It's a liquid material. It is an edible oil which is used for cooking food. We can take the test tube and fill it with water, add some mustard oil to it, shake the test tube well and allow it to stand for some time. We will see two separate layers of water and the mustard oil in the test tube. Water being heavier forms the lower layer in the test tube, whereas the mustard oil being lighter forms the upper layer. So two layers you will see. This shows that the mustard oil does not mix up with water. So we can say that the mustard oil is insoluble in water or mustard oil is immiscible with water. So some other example like groundnut oil, coconut oil, kerosene, petrol are the materials which are insoluble in water or immiscible with water. Please note that those liquids which do not mix with water, however, mix with among themselves also. For example, groundnut oil can mix with coconut oil to form a single layer. Similarly, Kerosene can mix up with petrol to form a single layer. Activity third. Take 2 beakers, fill it with water. In first beaker, drop an iron nail in it. In second beaker, put piece of wood in it. In first beaker, we will see that the iron nail sinks in the water and settles down at the bottom of the beaker. This activity shows that the iron is a material which is heavier than water. So some materials which are heavier than water, like iron, aluminium, copper, silver, gold, chalk, soil, etc., which are heavier than water, sinks in the water. Whereas piece of wood being lighter in the weight, it does not sink in the water. This activity shows that the wood is a material which is lighter than water. So some of the example of the material which are lighter than water are wood, plastic, sawdust, dry leaves, etc. And all the materials which are lighter than water floats on the surface of the water. Activity 4. Translucent objects are translucent material. We can make it by ourselves also. Take a sheet of paper and look through it at a burning candle. We will not able to see much candlelight through this sheet of paper. Now put 5 to 6 drops of coconut oil on it and spread it and rub the oil on the paper with your fingers. This gives us an oiled paper. Now your paper has become oiled paper completely. Now let us look at the burning candle through that part of the paper on which the oil has been rubbed. We will find that the more light of the candle can be seen through the oiled paper, which is a translucent material. Please note that though we can see more candle light coming through the oiled paper, but we cannot see candle flame clearly. So the things through which we cannot see clearly are known as the translucent objects. Next, activity 5. This you can make it by your own. At home also you can practice it. Now let us find out whether the palm of our hand is a transparent, translucent or an opaque. This can be done as follows. You can take one torch at your home, torch is there, and cover its glass with the palm of your hand in a dark room. Go to dark room and cover that torch glass with your palm. Switch on the light of the torch, then you switch on and observe the other side of the palm. We can see some faint red light through our palm. Since the palm allows some light to pass through it, so it is a translucent material. And opaque. Objects through which, like a wall, wooden, cardboard, stand behind that wall and try to see. You won't be able to see. So this type of the objects through which image are not seen at all, that type of the objects are known as the opaque objects. Thank you, student.